amen. Brother Cain, amen, was having liver failure. When he went back to the doctor last week, amen. Doctor couldn't find nothing wrong with him. He thought he was going to be on dialysis, amen, and got back and kidneys and everything functioning at 100%, amen. In the Lord, in the book of Ephesians, amen, give you your word for the year, amen. And there is a word from the Lord, amen. The second chapter of Ephesians, verses 8, 9, and 10, amen. Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8, 9, and 10. And say amen. Amen. For by grace are ye saved through faith. And that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God had before ordained that we should walk in them. Amen. 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 Word of God for the people of God. May you be blessed in the presence of the Lord. Amen. We want to thank God for Pastor Horn being here tonight. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Amen. I want to talk from the power. Amen. In 2011, I'm getting a blessing from heaven. In 2011, I'm getting a blessing from heaven. Why do you say that, Reverend? Because 2010, I prayed for some things that didn't happen. In 2010, I went through some things that I feel or felt was unjust. But yet I kept on praying. And I believe God to be a prayer hearing and a prayer answering God. So if I didn't get it in 2010, faith says that in 2011, I'm getting a blessing from heaven. I don't want no blessing from the folks. I appreciate all that you've done, but I want a blessing that I know come directly from the Lord. Because the word of God tells us that every good and perfect gift come down from the Father of life. I want a blessing from God, because when God blesses you, the devil in hell can't do nothing about it. I want a blessing from God, because God is not an Indian giver. God does not bless you and turn around and talk about what he done for you. So I made up my mind that in 2011, I'm getting a blessing from heaven. And I can prove it tonight in the text where Paul wrote to the church at Ephesus while being in prison down in Rome around the year AD 60. When Paul wrote in this second chapter, he was talking about the spiritual dead being made alive. I wish I had some Bible readers there. Let me just look at the text so I have time to finish tonight. Look at what Paul said when he started at verse 1. He said, and you have been quickened who were dead in trespasses and sins, where in time past you walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. Paul is saying that in 2011, we're getting a blessing from heaven, because Paul is saying in the text that he got a blessing somebody who would just take a moment and look back at 2010 and see what God wants you to do. When there are times when you felt like you ain't gonna make it, when there are times when you didn't know how you were gonna make it, but somehow and some way God made a way out of no way. Somehow and some way God brought you in spite of. Look at what Paul is saying. Even back then, when I wasn't ready to die and wasn't fit to live, when I remember what I used to do, I wish I had somebody. Paul said, when I remember how I used to be, and Paul was saying, I wasn't born with a Bible. I didn't come out quoting John 3:17. Some of us still cussing and fussing, but when you remember where God brought you from, and so if God brought me from the drug house, if God brought me from the liquor house, if God brought me from the jail house, somebody said he didn't bring me this far to leave me. And if God had brought you to 2011, he didn't leave you in 2010, then God didn't bring you 2011 to leave you now. So tell your neighbor, in 2011, I'm getting a blessing from heaven. A blessing is for the name. Said it like this. Paul said, among sinners, I am chief. You got to know Paul passed. Paul was standing there in the book of Acts when they stoned Stephen to death. Is that right? Paul was standing there when they started throwing stones at him and they couldn't throw hard enough. They took their coats off. The Bible said they laid them at the feet of a young man whose name was Saul. He went to the high priest, demanded letters that he might go up to the church in Jerusalem just to wreak havoc, just to raise hell. I mean, no, Paul just wanted to go to church to raise hell. Tell your neighbor now, in 2011, I'm not going to church to raise hell. I'm not going to church to fuss and cuss. I'm not going to church to fight. But I'm going to house to worship. I'm going to the house to pray. I'm going in the house to pray. Because when praises go up, blessings come down. And I'm tired of you hindering my blessing with all of this fussing. I'm tired of you hindering my praying with all of this raising saying. I need a blessing from heaven in 2011. Look at Paul. We can have it in the church. And Paul said, I remember all of that. I remember how bad I was. But Paul said, there's something else I remember. I was on my way. Oh, y'all don't hear me. I was on my way up to the church to wreak havoc when a light shined from heaven, knocked me off my feet. I fell on my back and I said, Lord, who art thou? And he said, I'm the Lord Jesus whom you persecuted. It's hard to kick against the prick. He said, Lord, what would you have me to do? Paul said, get up, Paul. I want you to go to a street called Straight Street and go to one Ananias' house, and he'll tell you what to do because he's praying for you. So Paul was saying, I was a hellraiser, but now I'm a praying man. Oh, I used to fuss and cuff, but now I get my praise on. Should be all over. Oh, yeah. When you remember your past, we get in church. Oh, y'all ain't got to say amen. When God cleared us up from the bitch, we start walking around like we all this and all that. Like somebody owe us something. Like we ain't never did nothing. God pointing fingers at other folks. And don't realize you got three pointing right back at you. I wish I had some witnesses in here tonight. You better see what Paul's saying. Before you get too epic. Before you get too high class. Before you start thinking that you have arrived. You better keep reading in the text. And see what Paul got to say. Look at what Paul says. Verse 3, Paul says, among whom also we had our conversation in times past in the lust of the flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children.